Well, chances are you won't find many cowboys roaming the streets of Toronto, let alone a Jewish cowboy. But the CBC's Dana Glassman found one who's had an interest in the Wild West for as long as he can remember.
Unless you were a fan of old Western flicks, you probably don't come across a cowboy very often. But Hi Burstein is every bit the rugged Western horseback adventurer. At 76, he still rides several times a week at his hobby farm in Bolton, often braving mean winter weather.
I think I pushed about 15,000 head of cattle over the period of 20 years. I also probably rode about 50,000 kilometers.
Burstein has captured his horseback escapades in a book called Ride 'em, Jewish Cowboy. It chronicles his journeys moving cattle through the U.S., Italy, Spain, Portugal, Turkey, Israel, Africa, and Australia.
I highly recommend it to people who want to travel. Instead of taking a car or a bus, take a horse. Moy has a horse called Pilot.
Burstein's love of horses extends beyond the barn. Practically every one of his prized possessions, from his artwork to his living room chairs, feature images of horses, all except for a sculpture of Moses, a testament to his Jewish faith.
I've run into some anti-Semitism many times on the horseback, so sometimes I had to counter that. So that's why I feel strongly that I'm a Jewish cowboy, and I'm proud of it. Here's my daughter with her husband, Bruce. Here's Sean, the youngest boy.
A love of horses is in the Burstein genes. Hi's five sons and his daughter have all taken up riding because of their cowboy dad, who they say is the real deal.
He lives like he lives in the 1800s, back in Montana, Wyoming days. General Custer, who else? John Wayne.
Over the years, Burstein has survived run-ins with lions, bull elephants, and a bad fall 4 years ago when he was thrown from his horse in Turkey. But he says that he's going to continue riding for as long as he can.
As long as I'm healthy and strong, I can get on the horse, get off. That's very important.
And just as important for Burstein is to keep searching for that rare winter sunset. Dana Glassman, CBC News, Toronto.